Good morning, fifth class children. In the previous videos, what we have learned? We have learned small tables and charts, children. In that, how to draw pictographs completed, box chart and bar graphs also completed, children. Now today, let us learn circular graph or pie chart. Circular graph is also called pie chart. What is a pie chart? A pie chart is circular in shape. A pie chart is circular in shape. A pie chart is a chart in which a circle is divided into parts. A pie chart is a chart in which a circle is divided into parts. Now, a pie graph shows the relationship of parts of a whole circle. A pie graph shows the relationship of parts of a whole circle and how a whole circle is divided. Okay. So, here is an example, children. Look, there are 24 hours in a day. How many hours in a day? 24 hours. So, here one boy, Rahul. Rahul spent 8 hours at school. He spent 8 hours at school. And another 8 hours in sleeping. Another 8 hours sleeping. And 2 hours in playing. Another 2 hours for studying. And 4 hours for watching TV and other activities. So, total in 24 hours, he spent 8 hours at school, 8 hours in sleeping, 2 hours playing, 2 hours for studying and 4 hours for watching TV and other activities. So, 8 plus 8 how much? 16. 16 plus 2? 18. 18 plus 2? 20. 20 plus 4? 24. Total 24 hours. Now, by using this information, you have to make a pie chart, children. Okay. So, first divide 24 hours into 3 parts, children. So, if you divide 24 with 8, then you will get 3. 8 threes are 24. Okay, 24 divided by 8 is equal to 3. So, 24 hours divided with 8, then you will get 3 parts. Look here, these are the 3 parts. 3 parts have how many hours? Each have 8 hours, 8 hours, 8 hours. So, for the first 8 hours, what he done? At school. He spent at school. So, this is school. And another 8 hours? He sleeping. Sleeping. Another 8 hours? Sleep. So, there is a another 8 hours. Third part. So, here look. 2 hours playing. 2 hours for studying. 4 hours for watching. So, here this 8 hours means 1 by 3 part. 1 by 3 part. 1 by 3 part. Here, you will make 2 8 hours into 4 hours. You divide with 1 by 2. So, 1 by 3, 1 by 2 how much? 1 by 6. So, 1 by 6 means 4 hours. If you divide with 2, it will change into 4 hours. So, 4 hours is equal to 1 by 6 part. And if you divide 4 hours with 2, 4 divided by 2, then you will get 2 hours. Means 1 by 6 into 1 by 2. 1 by 12 power. 1 by 12 power. Now look, children. Here 2 hours in playing. So 2 hours means how many parts, children? 1 by 12 power. Look here. If you divide this exactly off, it is 4 hours, 4 hours. Means 1 by 6 part, 1 by 12 part for playing. This is 1 by 3. This is also 1 by 3. Next, another 2 hours for studying. So, another part, 1 by 12 hour. This is also for studying. Next, the remaining 4 hours, that is 1 by 6 part. What he done for 4 hours? Watching TV and other activities. Watching TV and other activities. Okay, children, let us open your course book, page number 55, children.
Let us see page number 55 in your course book, children. This is the example. So Rahul spent 8 hours at school, 8 hours for sleeping, another 8 hours for other activities. That is 2 hours for playing, 2 hours for studying and 4 hours for watching TV. So here, draw a circle and divide it into 3 parts as 24 divided by 8 is equal to 3. So each part is 1/3 of the whole. The other 1 by 3 part is made into half. That is 1 by 3 by 2 means 1 by 3 into 1 by 2. So 1 into 1, 1 divided by 3 into 2, 6. 1 by 6 part. So 1 by 6 part represent 4 hours of watching TV and other activities. The remaining 1 by 6 part. So this is 1 by 6. This is totally 1 by 3 part. So here we made this into half. That is 1 by 6, 1 by 6. 2 1 by 6 parts. So 1 by 6 part represent watching TV and another activities. So the remaining 1 by 6 part again divided into 2 halves. So 1 by 6 into 1 by 2 means 1 by 12 part. 1 by 12 part represent playing. Another 1 by 12 represent study. Okay, now look here. Finally, the complete pie chart is shown here. It is important to give a title to the graph. So, first 1 by 3 part, that is school, he spent at school. Another 1 by 3 part, sleep. Next, 1 by 6 part, watching TV and offer other activities. Next, the remaining 1 by 6 part also divided into half. So, 1 by 12, 1 by 12 for playing and for study. Okay, now let us open your workbook, children. 5th class children, this is your workbook. Now open page number 38. Look here. Smart tables and charts. 4 boys sold popcorn for 1 month. Each of them has collected money as shown below. So these 4 boys sold popcorn for 1 month and they have collected some money. So that money is given here. So this boy Sanjay, this boy named Sanjay. So he collected 8000 rupees. He is John. He collected 7000 rupees. He is Anwar. He collected 9000 rupees. He is Siddhu. And he collected 6000 rupees. And now let us use this information to complete the pictograph below and answer the questions that follow. So here they given some model of pictograph, children, and asking to complete this pictograph. So name Sanjay, John, Anwar, Siddhu. This is the title, money collected. And here is a key also. Each 1 rupee coin represent 1000. 1 rupee coin represent 1000. And some questions also given here. So first complete this. Sanjay collected how much money? 8000 rupees. Means here you have to draw pictures. Which pictures? 1 rupee pictures. So each 1 rupee represent 1000 rupees. So here for the 8000 you have to draw 8 1 rupee symbols. And next John. 7000. So draw 7. Anwar 9000. Draw 9 1 rupee coins. Sidhu, draw 6000. Draw 6 1 rupee coins. Okay. Now look, children. Draw 1 rupee coins like this, children. So each one represent 1000. So here Sanjay collected 8000 rupees. 8000 rupees. So here I draw 8 1 rupee coins. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. And next John collected 7000. Now draw 7 1 rupee coins. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Next Anwar collected 9000 rupees. Now draw 9 1 rupee coins. 5 6 7 8 9. And next Sidhu collected 6000 rupees. Now draw 6 1 rupee coins. Okay. Now let us see question and answers, children. Questions, you have to answer them. How much money did the boys collected in all? How much money did the boys collected in all? Now total. Now count all the 1 rupees coins here, children. Here Sanjay, this row represent 8. This represent 7. This one 9. The last Sidhu 6. Now add these. 8 plus 7 15. 15 plus 9 24. 24 plus 6 30. 31 rupee coin. So each 1 rupee coin represent 1000. 31 rupee coins represent 30,000. So rupees 30,000. Okay, next one. How much more money did Anwar collected than Sidhu? So look here. Anwar collected 9000 rupees and Sidhu collected 6000 rupees. So 6 coins, 9 coins. What is the difference between those? So the difference between these is 9, 6. What is the difference? 3 1 rupee coins means 3000 rupees. How much? 3000 rupees. Okay. So here Anwar collected 3000 rupees more than Sidhu. Next, who sold more popcorn than John but less than Anwar? Now observe these, children. Anwar 9 and who is the another person? John. John collected 7. More than John and less than Anwar. What is the number? 6 or 8? Very good, 8. The number that is more than 7 and less than 9 is 8. So 8000 rupees. Who collected? Sanjay. So write the name spelling Sanjay. Okay, now come to the next page. The number of cars of a particular model produced in the years 2010, 11, 12, 13 and 14 is as follows. Draw a pictograph to represent the data. So years and quantity are given here, children. So in the 2010, they produced 50,000. 2011, 60,000. 2012, 55,000. 2013, 65,000. 2014, 70,000. Okay. So here you have to draw a pictograph to represent this data. So first, write key, children. Write key. So if you draw a car, so draw cars, children, car symbol. So each car symbol represent 10,000 cars. Okay. Each car symbol represent 10,000 cars. Now here you have to draw a pictograph. So give a title here, children. Cars produced. Cars produced. And draw car pictures here. For the 50,000 here, you have to draw 5 cars. 60,000, 6 cars. 55,000, 5 cars. And draw a half car, children. Draw a half car. So, half car represent, draw like this, this half car represent 5,000. So, here 5 full cars and 1 half car. Here 65,000, 6 full cars and 5 half car. 70,000, 7 cars. Okay, children, draw. Okay, draw cars like this, children. So, here 5. 6, 5 and half car. Half car represent 5,000. Next, 6 plus half car. Next, 7 cars. Okay, children, there is another example that when we look in the next, we will do in the next video, children. Now, today I am ending this video up to here, children. Okay.